Greetings folks, this video is going to be an overview of this beast. It's the Foxtec H-Wing VTOL. It is a 1.2 meter wingspan, hybrid of a wing and a quad from a company called Foxtec. Who are Foxtec? There are a few Foxtec companies around the world. This is Foxtec.com from China. They are a company that specialise in industrial grade, high-end, high-tech, heavy lifting, multi-rotors, UAVs, VTOLs. And it's worth going and having a look at their store, foxtecfpv.com, and just check out some of the incredible things that they sell. This is just a personal interest sort of thing. But check out that Foxtec Rex 340 Canard hybrid VTOL drone. It is around about the 30,000 US mark. It's a hybrid between a Canard and a quad or VTOL. 32 kilogram maximum takeoff weight, and just an amazing looking piece of technology. Anyway, have a look at the store and just drool over some of the products they've got for sale there. But let's talk about the H-Wing VTOL. This is sort of like the Foxtec's entry into the recreational market, I guess. Comes ready to fly with controller, 6004S lithium ion battery pack in a suitcase. I'll show you how it all fits in there in a minute. Price of this one is about $650 US, but that is absolutely complete, ready to fly. They say it has an 18-minute flight time as a multi-rotor, or up to 40 minute flight time as a wing. So people have been asking me, wouldn't it be better to have either a quad or a wing? But VTOLs are kind of an investigation into the combination of characteristics that a wing doesn't have, like a wing can't land vertically and a quad sort of can't fly horizontally and long distances efficiently. So it's taking those two aspects from the different components and hopefully putting them together. It's designed to have a GoPro in the nose here. It has a sort of a weighted block there at the moment, but as you can see here, you can put the GoPro, fits in there perfectly. This one's a GoPro 7. They say it's compatible with the GoPro 8 and I assume the GoPro 9. Inbuilt FPV camera. It has 2.4 gigahertz long range RC and FPV link, maximum range of up to 10 kilometers, which is very impressive. It has GPS, position hold, altitude hold, return to home, all that good stuff. It is based on Arduino, but it's all pre-set up. You don't have to do anything, as far as I know. Comes with an app that you get from Foxtec called HEQ FPV app. And that gives you FPV and control on the screen of your phone. You mount your phone on here. I'll show you all of that a little bit later on. There's USB connection from the phone to the controller, as well as Bluetooth connection. That had me confused for a little while. You can also use Q ground control. And it says it has attitude protection, stall protection, altitude protection, RC lost return, and low voltage return as well. Takeoff weight is 1.55 kilograms. Maximum payload is 150 grams. I'm imagining you could put a DJI air unit on here somewhere so I can get spectacular quality FPV. Haven't really worked out the FPV stuff yet. That will come. 9x6 self-tightening props. Control range 10 kilometers and flying range 25 kilometers. And you have push button switch between VTOL and wing mode, and push button return to home and land as well. Now, if we take the cover off here, we can have a look inside, and we have, it is based on an F765 board, onboard barometer and SD card reader. Has a pitot tube airspeed sensor up in the nose there, and USB connection as well, so you can configure it. And GPS in the top of the lid there that connects into the board. Now you can see the motors are kind of angled in and out, which is quite interesting. Everything just clicks together. The wing just pulls off and the electrical connections are made when you put the legs and the motors in, and then you just end up with the center pod there. And it all comes packed down in a suitcase, which I'll show you how it packs down now. It makes it very convenient for packing down and traveling. Center section there, controller in there, battery 6004S. There's the phone mount for the controller. We have a lanyard there, nuts and bolts for the top, a couple of different sorts of USB cables, got a USB-C and a USB, a micro USB, depending on your phone connection. Mine's USB-C, so I'll leave that out there. Have the wings here, or the wing ends. And the arms and motors, and self-tightening props there. So the motor pods slide on and make the connection. Like that. Winglets pop in like this. And the props just spin on by themselves like that. Tighten them up. There we go. So now we're ready to connect up and continue on. I'll connect it all up now and show you how that all works. Connect up the battery first. Now we can connect up the USB. Turn the controller on. Turn on the app, HEQ Fly. Yes to that. So now you can see we have, there's the FPV view there. Now we have to connect by Bluetooth as well. The T10392 is the one to connect to. There we go, we're connected. Go through some of the calibration and safety checks. You can preset the safe altitude, geofence radius and height. All right, I'll take the craft outside now and... Okay, we've got four satellites now. Still waiting for a 3D lock. We need at least six, I would imagine. Okay, after waiting for a little while, we now have 12 satellites and it has established a 3D lock. We can check that by switching this switch here into position hold, and it will say position. Otherwise it'll throw up an error. So we have it all working nicely now. The GPS is working. Did take a little bit of backwards and forwards to Foxtech to get the GPS working in Australia as opposed to China. It was acquiring lots of satellites but just wouldn't lock in home position. That's now working nicely. I have had it out for a brief fly, but not very much. So this video won't be a flying review, just the overview really. I've just used it as a quad, hovering around, getting used to the controls. I haven't switched it into wing mode yet. That will be coming very soon, as soon as the weather plays ball and a few other things that are holding me up. But certainly looks like it's all working nicely. Just flies normally like a GPS and stabilized DJI quad, really, in quad mode. And most importantly, it lands nice and stably, just sort of reverses down onto the ground. And most importantly, it lands nice and stably, just sort of reverses down onto the ground. So I'm looking forward to working out how to fly it properly, getting some decent weather so that we can fully put it through its paces. The product link is in the description, of course, and Foxtech have given me a discount code. So make sure you check out the link, check out the other things on the Foxtech website too. There are some fascinating VTOL style craft on there. Thanks very much for watching, and flight video coming up soon.